Welcome to the course on design of machine elements. In this lecture, we are discussing few problems related to design of keys. So first problem is a square key is to be used to key a gear to a 35 mm diameter shaft. The hub length of the gear is 60 mm. Both shaft and key are to be made of the same material, having an allowable shear stress of 35 MPa. What are the minimum dimensions for the sides of the square key? If 400 Nm of torque is to be transmitted. Okay, so we have to design a square key. So the first design step is over. We have to design a square key. So in the problem itself, it is mentioned that the type of key used is square key. So when we are discussing about different topics, so in some cases we have to choose whether we have to select a square key or rectangular key. So that is done by comparing the value of sigma, ck and 2 tau k that we have already discussed while discussing the equations for designing. We will check sigma, ck, we will check whether there is a relation exists between sigma, ck and 2 tau k. If sigma, ck is equal to 2 tau k, we choose square key, and if sigma, ck not equal to 2 tau k, we will choose a rectangular key. But here such a problem is not there, because in the problem itself it is mentioned that you have to choose a square key. So we are going to design a square key. And this square key is used to connect a gear to a shaft. So the given diameters are diameter of the shaft is given. Diameter of the shaft is 35 mm. The hub length of the gear is 60 mm. Hub length of the gear is equal to 60 mm. Then what is the importance of this hub length? Hub length, the importance is, I will just draw the sample figure. This is our shaft. In this shaft, there is a gear. There is a gear, and this length, this is the hub of the gear. This portion is the hub of the gear. This is the hub length. Hub length. Hub length means this portion is coming in contact with the shaft. So hub length is 60 mm. So the length of the key. So why we are using a key? The key is used for connecting the hub with the shafts. Okay, so there will be a key way both in the shaft as well as in the hub. So we have to, the key length should be minimum 60 mm. Okay. This is the gear, and this is the hub of the gear. So the key, there will be a key which is connected at like this. So minimum length. So the minimum length of the key should be 60 mm. So we have from this data we have decided the length of the key, that is 60 mm. The length of the key L is equal to 60 mm. Now the allowable shear stress for key and shaft material. Allowable shear stress for key and shaft material, tau k is equal to 35 MPa. 35 MPa is means 35 N/mm². Now the torque transmitted is also given. Torque transmitted, so I am taking it as maximum torque transmitted, is equal to 400 Nm, which is equal to 400 into 10 raised to 3 Newton mm. This is the maximum torque that has been transmitted. Why we are converting this Newton meter into Newton mm? Because all our calculations are based on millimeter. The length of the key is in millimeter. The allowable shear stress is given in 35 Nm/mm², so we have to convert the torque transmitted in Newton meter into Newton mm. So we already discussed an expression for the induced shear stress in a key, that is induced shear stress in key, so ki is equal to 2 Tmax divided by LWD. So what is this expression? This expression gives when a torque Tmax is transmitted by a key having length L, width W and the shaft diameter D, the induced shear stress will be tau ki. But here the torque transmitted is given as 400 Nm and the allowable shear stress is given as 35 MPa. So the maximum allowable shear stress, maximum allowable shear stress tau k is given as 35 N/mm². And what you have to find? So it should transmit 400 N/3 N/mm of torque, and the shear allowable shear stress should limit up to 35 N/mm². And length we have taken as 60 mm. Then what should be the width? The diameter of the shaft we have already know, it is 35 mm. What should be the width of the key? So width of the key W is equal to 2 Tmax. So from this equation we are taking W into the left side, so 2 Tmax divided by L into tau k into D. W is equal to 2 Tmax divided by L into tau k into D, which is equal to 2 into 400 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 60 into 35 into 35. This is the permissible shear stress and this is the diameter of the shaft. So this is equal to 10.88 mm. So we will not, the next standard size is 12 mm. So we will not take 11 mm, 12 mm is standard size. So we will take width as 12 mm. So we know that our key is a square key, so width is equal to 12 mm, thickness is equal to 12 mm, and length we have not determined as 60 mm. So this is our key having width and thickness 12 mm and length 60 mm. So this, the minimum, the question is the, what is the minimum dimensions for the sides of the square key? The minimum dimension should be 12 mm.